I'm Sebastian St. James. The way you think about return on investment and profit is wrong. In a survey I did, I found that 90% of people misunderstood return on investment because they didn't understand one key fact. Here is a story. You buy a house which is worth $500,000. Here is your house. Oh, it's a lovely house. Multi-story, yes, a lovely lawn. And you lease out your house to a family. And here's a family, smiling, happy. As you know, if you've ever had an investment property, 100% of tenants are amazing and well-adjusted people. Of course, that's always true about tenants. The tenants pay $50,000 a year in rent. The property you purchased 10 years ago, it was $500,000 when you purchased it. Its current value now is $1 million. That probably sounds about right. Therefore, your return on investment is either A, 50K, which is the rent, divided by 500K, the original purchase price, which equals 10%. Or B, the rent divided by the current value, which is $1 million, or 1,000K, as I put it in K terms, equals 5%. In other words, return on investment is either rent divided by purchase price, in this case 10%, or rent divided by current value, which is 5%. Whichever seems more natural to you, lock in that answer. Now memorize the one you've chosen, no changing your mind. Here's a second story. You buy shares in a mining company. And here's the company now. Wow, that's impressive with all the lights and the great big teeth. No wonder you bought the shares. 10 years ago, you purchased it for $100,000. The current value is $200,000 today. You're paid a dividend of $10,000 per year. Your return on investment is either A, $10,000, which is the return on dividend, divided by 100K, which is the original purchase price, equals 10%, or B, 10K divided by 200K equals 5%. In other words, your return on investment is dividends divided by purchase price or dividends divided by current value. Lock in your answer, and once you've chosen it, you don't get to change your mind. Remember the answer to this question, remember the answer to the previous question, and lock them in. Have you chosen A for both or B for both? Or maybe you chose A for one and B for the other, which I will find very interesting. Here is a third story. You deposit $20,000 into a bank. The original deposit is $20,000 10 years ago. Boy, a lot of growth has happened in 10 years. The bank balance as of today is $40,000. The interest paid by your bank is going to be $2,000. Is your return on investment going to be 2K divided by 20K, which is 10%, or 2K divided by 40K, which is 5%? Is your return on investment going to be your interest divided by your original deposit, which is 10%, or interest divided by bank balance, which is 5%? Once again, lock in your answer and no changing your mind. Well, that was interesting. Have you chosen A for all your answers? Have you chosen B for all your answers, or are your answers all mixed up? And if so, is it the bank one that is different? If so, that will tell me something about you as well. So what is the correct answer? Is it A or is it B? The astute amongst you will notice I'm actually asking the same question over and over again. Once about a house, next about dividends, next about a bank account, but it's actually the same question asked in each time. So if you've got different answers, that's interesting. In each case, we're asking the return on investment. Is it return over original value or is it return over current value? Always A, always B. So, which is the correct answer? One answer is right, the other answer is a myth. I'm bringing out another video shortly which will bust another investment myth. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out. So, which is the right answer? The easiest way to understand this is to think about a bank account. Your original deposit was $20,000 10 years ago. Your current balance is $40,000. Now, a new bank is going to offer you 7% interest. Sounds pretty good in today's terms. So, in the new bank, you would deposit $40,000 at 7% interest, which would equal $2,800 in interest. You don't have to do the math yourself. I do math on YouTube, so you don't have to. In contrast, my bank, with a deposit of $20,000, the balance now is $40,000, is offering interest of $2,000. Okay, let's do the math. That's either $2,000 divided by my original deposit at $20,000, which equals 10%, or are they offering $2,000 divided by $40,000, which is 5%? In other words, do I do the interest calculation on interest divided by original deposit or interest divided by current balance? Think back to the original three questions you answered. Did you answer A or did you answer B? If you chose A, this is what you're saying. The new bank is offering me 7%, right? My bank is offering me 10%. I'm much better to stick with my current bank because it's offering me 10%. If on the original questions you answered option B, what you're saying is the new bank is offering me 7% interest. My bank is really offering me 5% interest, therefore I'm much better to switch to the new bank. Wow, well that's totally different. So based on whether your thinking is option A, then you stay with your same bank. Option B, then you go with a different bank. Well, which is true? They can't be both right. Actual interest, let's convert that into real dollars rather than percentages. The new bank is offering you $2,800 in interest. My bank is offering me $2,000 in interest. Oh, my bank is scheming, conniving, and is trying to underpay me. Based on those figures, the answer clearly is to go to the new bank. You'll make more profit. Now, which answer, A or B, actually gave us the right answer and had us move to the right bank? So the new bank is $2,800 or 7% interest. My bank is $2,000 underpaying me. If you said option A, then my bank you considered was paying me 10% interest. If you said option B, then my bank was paying me 5% interest. Quite clearly, $2,800 is more than $2,000. So my bank must be paying me 5% interest because I'm definitely switching to the new bank at 7%. If my math tells me my current bank is paying me 10% interest, obviously that's wrong because it's giving me $2,000 rather than $2,800. So return on investment should always be calculated on today's value. Mind blowing. But why is this the case? Why does math actually work out that way? The answer is because money is fungible. What does fungible mean? Fungible means that something is mutually interchangeable. If you have a $10 note and I take it from you and I give you back my $10, how much money do you have? Have you got the same exact money? No, as far as the note is concerned, but yes, as far as the value is concerned, because money is fungible, it is interchangeable, and it doesn't matter which you have as long as you've got the same value. If I take your wife and give you somebody else's wife, have you got the same amount of wife? Well, yes, you do, but it kind of matters. You don't have the same wife, which might be a good thing or might be a bad thing. Depends on your wife. But you see that wives are not fungible. You can't just take one and give me another one, and I can say, oh yeah, wake up the next morning in bed next to her and say, oh, it's the same wife. No, wives are not fungible, but money is. And so that makes a difference. Now, with our new understanding, let's go through the original problems. The house original purchase price was $500,000. The current value is $1,000,000. The rent was $50,000. This is from the original problem. If I calculated my percentage return on the original purchase price, that would be 10%. If I calculated it on today's value, that would be 5%. Remember, the new bank is offering me 7% interest. Should I switch? Should I sell the house and put my money in the new bank and get 7% interest? Yes or no? Well, the answer is yes, you should. Because it's actually 5% you're getting with your house, you're not getting 10% no matter how much you wish. Therefore, based on the math, you should sell up that house and then move to the new bank. Let's have a look at the shares. The purchase price was $100,000. The current value is $200,000. The dividend is $10,000 per year. This is the original problem. Is it $10,000 divided by $100,000, which is 10% interest, or is it 5% interest? New bank is offering me 7% interest. They're very persistent with this offer. Am I going to sell up my shares and put my money in the new bank, all other things considered? Well, the answer is yes, you should, because we actually always calculate over today's value. Therefore, it's actually 5% interest in the shares. Why not sell and get a guaranteed 7%? Well, new bank, you are getting my business every time. And because I've now discovered that return on investment is always calculated in today's value rather than the original value, then I can do the clear comparison. The reason is money's always fungible. I can always sell this, pop it into there, and get the new value. I don't really care about the original purchase price. But Sebastian, I always do my math based on the original purchase price. If I bought my house for $40,000 40 years ago, I'd like to think that I'm getting 700% return on my rent. Fine, you do you. But if you're trying to compare your rate of return on your rent against other potential investments that you could sell your house and get now, then comparing it against the original purchase price is of no value to you. So fine, if you want to do that, that's good. But don't use that as a way of comparing with other alternatives. Is there a time I would ever say, well, I purchased it for this price, therefore the amount of return I've made over 10 years is this amount? Yes, when I sell it. That's a good math equation to have then, because it's kind of interesting to me. How much money have I made over that period of time? We all do this. You buy your house, you keep it for 10 years, I bought it for this much, I'm now selling it for this much, therefore I've made such and such a percentage. Sure. Totally makes sense. But you're not trying to compare your house as an investment against other alternatives right then and there. And so when you sell something, yeah, you can make that comparison. So now that you know the math is always done on today's value, if you hear one of your friends saying, oh, I'm making 30% rent because I bought my house 20 years ago, you can roll your eyes and say, ugh. Whatever. Or someone else might say, dividends, at the moment I'm getting 30% return because I've held the shares for so long. Have you? That's nice for you, but that doesn't really tell me whether you're doing good or whether you're doing bad based on that math. Speaking about high dividend stocks, where can I find a list of high dividend stocks on the ASX? I've made a video about that. Go ahead and click on it here.